I want to talk to you today about a snake and an eagle. If you've gotten my email, you'll see the snake down there at the bottom with the eagle. And actually, you can't really see the snake very well. He's a tiny snake. And this actually works perfectly for our story today. Keeping your power. What does that mean? So an eagle's sitting in her nest, and up creeps this slimy snake. And as you can see in the picture, it's a small green one. But sometimes it could be a big, fat, mean one, right? And they sneak up to the eagle's nest, and they wrap themselves around the eagle's feet, and the eagle is bound by this snake. Now, she has two options in this moment. She can either reach down and use her sharp beak and peck at that snake, and that would probably be the easiest and quickest of the two options. The second option is to take off and fly, hoping that in the flight, gravity and the weight of the snake will cause it to plop to the ground, and she'll be free to soar off. Now, each and every one of us has this same option when we're faced with a problem, some kind of difficulty. Now, this difficulty, and this week has seen all ranges of difficulties with people that I've been talking to, including myself, from little things like a camera not working, or the weather not being quite right, to an accident, or a pipe breaking and your water being flooded, or your house being flooded. So every single day, there's a whole range of problems that accost us. And these are our snakes. These are the snakes that are creeping up into our nest at night, wrapping themselves around our power and trying to hold us down. Now, if we, like the eagle, bend down and start to peck at the problem, what happens? We actually make ourselves more vulnerable to that snake. We make ourselves more vulnerable to the problem. The problem becomes more real because we're trying to change something that's already happened. If I yell and scream and get upset because there's water cascading down from my ceiling, the water doesn't care. In fact, that makes me even powerless, and the water more powerful. It now has more power over me because it's making me mad. If, however, I stay calm and cool and collected and I look at the things that I'm grateful for, all the people that are helping me out and the resources that I have available to me, I all of a sudden have more power than the water can. I have more power than my next month's utility bill. I have more power than the damage that it might cause because I am focusing on the positive. And what does that look like for the eagle? That means taking off. That is the taking off. That is the flight for the eagle. So in every problem, you have two choices. You can reach down and peck at the problem, which actually brings you closer to it, and now it can strike out and sink its fangs into you, or you can take off. And you take off in a variety of ways. One way, as I mentioned, is to look at the positive. Another way is to look at what your dreams are, what your visions are, what your plans and future is. And that way, you realize that you're much more powerful. Your dreams are so much more powerful than your problems. Good luck with this. Remember, be the eagle that flies, not the eagle that pecks. See you next time.